Assalamu alaikum. Welcome all to the first webinar of the series Information and Dissemination Initiative taken by CPPAG upon the direction of NEPRA. I am Mohammed Kamal Ahmed. I will be moderator of this webinar. I'm the part of the strategy and market development team here at CPPAG. Along with me here today, Mr. Ibrar, lead design, Mr. Shahir Ali, lead PMO, Mr. Umar Haroon Malik, head strategy and market development. CPPAG has been mandated by ECC in 2015 for design and implementation of wholesale electricity market in Pakistan. Upon that mandate, CPPAG has made the design and submit to NEPRA. And NEPRA has approved the design and implementation roadmap in 2020. Upon the NEPRA's direction, this initiative has been taken. CPPAG has been building capacity of all the stakeholders and implementation agencies for the past 4 years. And upon the direction of NEPRA, this initiative has been taken for reaching the objective of CTBCM to the wider audience and for the layman. So this webinar is the first webinar in the future or upcoming future. Such webinars will be organized in regular frequent intervals. So with this opening, I will set the decorum for this webinar. Just like all the questions can be asked through the chat box and will be addressed at the end of the webinar. And if in any case, due to the shortage of time, if the questions have not been addressed, you can still may reach us through Ask a Question Query portal on the CPPAG website. So with this, I will request Mr. Ibrar, lead design, to please give us insight upon this webinar titled Introduction to Wholesale Electricity Market in Pakistan. Please, Mr. Ibrar.
Assalamu alaikum, everyone. My name is Ibrar Hussain. I'm by profession an electrical engineer and currently leading the detail design and product development portfolio here at the strategy and market development department of CPPAG. In today's session, I will give a brief introduction to the competitive wholesale market of Pakistan, which is going to be implemented in the next year. One thing to keep in mind for this session is that, as already mentioned, that this is the first session of a series of sessions to be organized by CPPAG, and the content will be more of an introductory nature, and we will cover the details in our upcoming session. So with this, the presentation is organized in six parts. In the first part, I will briefly cover the preamble and history of power. In the second part, we will cover briefly the history of power market development. We will talk about the global markets, how these markets were developed, and also the transition journey of the Pakistani market. Then we will cover international perspective, that how these markets are organized internationally and what are the key features of an electricity market design. Then we will come towards the Pakistani market design, which is being proposed and approved by the regulator and the federal government. And then in the part five, we will talk about the CTBCM implementation roadmap and the monitoring mechanism. And if times allow us in part six, we will cover the role of different institutions in CTBCM. So in the preamble, first, we have to understand that competition is good for the sector because it brings efficiency, it incentivizes innovation, and we have to work together to bring competition in the market, which will benefit all market participants. And CPPG has played a key role in preparation of this competitive market design, which has now been approved by the authority and also ratified by the federal government. And CPPG has also been assigned a central facilitator role to facilitate every entity in implementation of the respective action, because it's not only part of the CPPG to implement the wholesale market. There are stakeholders, there are service providers, which are going to implement their own actions, but CPPG is centrally coordinating this. And the update is that all entities have submitted their respective plans to the authority to implement their respective actions. This was how, what was the approach during development of this design and its approval. The process was that CPPAG did not prepare this session in isolation. There were a lot of consultative sessions, there were trainings, there were like meetings, there were certification courses and learning exchanges with different countries. The model has been put through public consultation twice, and we received more than 800 comments, which were responded comprehensively. And as a result, the conceptual as well as detailed design and its implementation roadmap has been approved by the regulator as well as ratified by the federal government. Okay, in order to check the robustness of the design, it was not that it CPPG prepared it with the help of international consultant, but the design was also verified by several experts, like the international consultant, which is hired by NAPRA. We had ratified the design from the EPH, which is the market operator of Turkey. PSR is a leading firm in the market design area, which is based in Brazil. Another international firm with the name of CRA, which is a global leader in market design, also reviewed the design. Other included Apexport and the Lungs Energy Institute. We have thoroughly reviewed the model and have given their inputs, which have been addressed. Another was the Security and Exchange Commission of Pakistan. There were consultations with them as well, and a special committee reviewed the design. There were international collaborations and physical visits to 10 markets. The team of CPPG has visited, physically visited 10 markets to learn lessons and implement here in Pakistan. A robust consultative process. It was always, like I mentioned, an inclusive approach. Everybody was taken on board. We have internal capable design and implementation team. We have world-class leaders in market design, the MRC consultants. Also through USAID, that support from TechTrack was available. And we have internally built an internal CPPA core team, which is dedicatedly working on this task. And there working groups are created in different entities. There are 16 entities, and collectively we call them as electricity market team. And there are these guys are trained on electricity market subjects and are actively participating in this activity. These are some pictorials of the consultative sessions and our certification program. This is our signature EMP program, which is being conducted by CPPG at LAMS. And these are the pictorials of the training and consultative sessions, which have been organized during the previous years. And in the second part, so we will be covering the power market development history globally and then in Pakistan. In earliest days, in 1882, the electricity was commercialized first through like low voltage DC line. And in 1886, the high voltage transmission system were built by Ganz and Co and Westinghouse, which enabled the long distance transmission of electricity at higher voltages. In earliest days, the model was that every company has to transmit and sell its power through its own cables. And the streets look like this. This is a pictorial. So, and the people in the business, they quickly learned that the wire business, this electricity business, considering the technology, so it's a monopoly business. They quickly learned that this is a natural monopoly. It cannot be done like this. So, in the most of the 20th century, when consumers wanted to buy electricity, they did not have any choice. They have to buy it from the local company which was serving that areas. And there were various forms of monopoly, like there was complete vertical integration, generation, transmission, distribution were completely integrated, like the WAPDA model in Pakistan. And another model was that there was monopoly in distribution, and this monopoly was buying from another greater monopoly on the transmission and level. Regarding ownership, there were two models. There were either private regulated entities or like public sector entities. But irrespective of the ownership or the level of vertical integration, like the geographic monopolies were the norm. Like there was a single supplier in a geographical area, and the consumer did not have any choice to buy from anybody else. They have to buy from this local monopolist. While people present in the current competitive market, they might tempted to think that this monopoly model is bad and they might have hurt the sector, but this is not true. The sector prospered a lot under this model. Electric utilities, they made truly remarkable contributions to the economic activity and quality of life. Access improved very quickly. New areas were electrified for several decades. Like electricity access was doubled every 8 years. The power transmitted through these lines by these monopoly entities, it doubled every 8 years. There were technological advancement, innovations, and like there was lines were built around thousands of kilometers, multiples of megawatts, kilowatts of voltage, and megawatts of power was able to transfer. And the sector prospered a lot under this model. However, in the 1980s, economists started arguing that this monopoly model, this has run its course. Now, it can, considering the advancement in technology and the experience with this model, the model can be changed. The reason was that what they argued economically, that the monopoly status, it removes the incentives to operate efficiently, and this encourages unnecessary investment, because what a local a monopolist, how it can gain return to because its return is guaranteed. So in order to enhance its returns, it invests more more and more, and there is no risk of loss of business. Whatever it charges, it can charge. And the another reason was that why if regulated private utility makes mistakes and make unnecessary investment, why the consumer has to bear the cost? So and the public utilities, they were very close to link to the government, and you can say when you are very close to the government, politics always interfere with the good economics. So this suggested an alternative that and argued that prices would be lower and the economy as a whole would benefit if the supply of electricity become the object of market forces, market discipline, instead of monopoly regulation or government policy. Considering this, Chile was the first country that implemented such kind of reforms in 1882, and this was followed by UK, other European countries, Latin America, and other United States. Several countries are currently at various stages. They started from one point and then doing reforms and making changes along the way. Some countries are now at wholesale market. Some countries have implemented wholesale with limited retail, and some countries have fully liberalized their market with full retail competition. Along this journey, there are success stories like many markets in America and Latin America, Europe, they are successful, but there are also spectacular failures like the case of Enron in California. And the journey is that you learn from the mistakes, and when the market fails, they reorganize the market, they implement in a different manner. So this is the kind of journey with electricity markets. This was a global perspective. Now coming to the power sector of Pakistan, that when this journey started in Pakistan, so the seed of the competitive market is coming from the 1992 WADA restructuring plan. Following the global trend, Pakistan also approved the first WADA strategic restructuring plan with three objectives: enhanced capital formation, efficiency, and rationale. And then the third objective was to move towards full competition and enhance the private participation in the power sector. The next important milestone was in 1994, Pakistan announced its first power policy to enable, which enabled the private sector participation in generation sector. This policy offered generous incentives to attract investment, and several deals were made, and the policy is considered successful in attracting investment in the power sector. Then the next important event is in 1997, the enactment of NEPRA Act, which established an independent regulator, NEPRA, to regulate the debundled entities. And in 1998, unbundling of WABDA, this took place. PEPCO was established as a transition company to manage the transition from vertical integration towards the debundled sector. And WABDA was debundled into generation, DISCOs, and NTDC. So on this timeline, another important event is in 2002, NTDC was given the transmission license by NEPRA, and was assigned four major roles. One was the transmission network operator to operate, construct the lines. Another role was the system operator to operate the system. And the third major role was the power purchasers to procure power on behalf of the distribution companies. And the fourth role was the contract registrar and power exchange administrator to facilitate the transition towards competitive market. As per license, NTDC was mandated to implement the wholesale market, the CDBCM, by 2008. In 2009, the CPPAG was legally incorporated, but however, it functioned as a department of NTDC from 2009 to 2015. In 2013, the government promulgated its national power policy. And one of the objectives of this policy was also to increase efficiency and to break the local monopolies and bring competition in the sector. I can go quickly on this timeline that in 2015, the ECC decided that CBBG shall develop this market model and submit it to regulator for approval. CBBG from 2016-17 did numerous consultative sessions and presented the submitted the design to NEPRA in March 2018, which was and NEPRA approved the design in December 2019, high level design, and in November 2019, it approved the detailed design as well as its implementation roadmap. So focusing on the market development journey, which started in 2015 and continued to 2018 for through like training sessions, consultative sessions, and the model was built, submitted in March 2018 to NEPRA, which was approved in December 2019. And in October 2020, NEPRA approved the high-level model, and also ACC gave extension of 1.5 years after approval of NEPRA that the market shall be implemented. And now the target date is April 2022 for the competitive market operation day. So this was a journey of Pakistan. We have reached to part three, in which we will cover the international perspective, that how the electricity markets are organized globally. On this screen, we have mapped nine markets with their design parameters. So the major message that we can learn from this screen is that every market design is unique. There is no like a copy paste solution or good for all solution that you can implement everywhere. Every country has to consider its own environment, its own legacy, and its own economic social conditions, and then has to implement tailor its design according to its own needs. Another major message from this slide is that broadly speaking, there are like eight design parameters which like distinguish different markets. But the basic difference is based on the how the dispatch of the power plants is decided. There are two models. One is one called the gross pool, and another one is called a net pool model. In the gross pool model, the system is optimized. The dispatch of the power plant is decided by the system operator, which generates the responsibility of generating the electricity at least cost lies with the system operator. It has all the information regarding economic parameters, dispatch parameters of every plant, and decides based on tools or based on criteria that in order to meet the total system, which generator needs to be dispatched. While the other model, in the self-dispatch model, the dispatch of the power plants is decided by the power plants itself, and the system operator only ensures the security of the system to check the feasibility of the bilaterally agreed quantities and manage the system through other mechanisms, through ancillary services or other mechanism. So there are two models. One are the economic dispatch model, which is implemented in like Latin America, US and Pakistan as well. And the other self-dispatch model that is implemented in Europe and Turkey in these countries. So these are the two key messages from this slide. Another important aspect is that market transition. It's not an automatic process. Like tomorrow the government announces that we will be in a competitive market. So this will not happen automatically. It requires a lot of actions to be taken, a lot of activities to be undertaken. First one is the legal, that either your law allows you to go into a competitive market or not. And the next is that if the law allow you, your policy and regulatory framework, this must be aligned with your legal framework, with the spirit of the law. And it's a big undertaking that you need to align all your policies and all your rules and regulations with the law. The next is the institutional framework, like all the roles of each institutions, they must be aligned with the legal and legal policy and regulatory framework. Each entity has to perform its own. Each entity must be clearly, the role of each entity must be clearly defined in these like policy and regulatory frameworks in order to perform its functions efficiently. So there will be market players, there will be like rights and obligations that needs to be established for each like service provider, market participant. Like we have in Pakistan, we have NTDC as transmission service provider. We have the Department of NTDC and PCC as the system operator. So their rules and regulations, their actions, they must be clearly defined. We have the market operator, which is currently CBBIG. We have other service providers that are proposed in CTBC, like the IEA and the SPT. We have the distribution companies, which provides the roles of suppliers as well as the DNO, distribution network owners. We have market participants, generation traders. So their roles and responsibilities must be clearly defined. Their capacity must be built. Their processes must be like automation, and there must be technological deployment. And if we talk about market transition, so the transition is from vertically integrated monopoly towards single buyer model, which is the current model, and then the single buyer plus, and then we will go competitive and wholesale and retail markets gradually. Competition. When we talk about competition, so it's always equal to liberalization, means private participation. The more you enhance private participation, the more you enhance competition. So the major message from this slide is that when you want to increase the level of competition, you must increase the level of liberalization, like the private participation. So before going into the details of the design, it is important to first understand that what kind of market players will be there in the market. So there are two broad categories of market players. One are the market participants, and the other category is the service providers. So who are the market participants? Market participants are those which are trading like electricity in the market. Like they are impacting from the market price, from the changes in the market price, they take the direct impact of the market price. While the other service provider, they facilitate the trade. They do not actually trade the products, or if you say in part the electricity, but they facilitate this trading. So in the market, in market participants, we have like the discos as suppliers. We have another kind of supplier, the competitive supplier. We have generators, traders, and the eligible, or we call it in Pakistan, BPCs, which will be market participant. On the service providers, we have the wire business, like the transmission and distribution business. We have market operator, we have system operator, the special purpose trader, and the independent auction administrator. Also, two important kind of market players are the consumers and suppliers. And their types must be understood. Consumers are of two types. One are called like the non-eligible or the non-BPC customers. They're also called regulated tariff customers, which do not have the choice to change their supplier. They must buy from their local supplier. And the other kind is what internationally called eligible consumers, and in Pakistan they are called the BPCs. So these consumers have the choice to change their supplier. And in NEPRA Act, the threshold to be like the BPC is 1 megawatt and above. And on the part of suppliers, suppliers are those entities which supply to the consumers. So there are also two types of suppliers. One are like the default supplier, or call it the base supplier, which sell at regulated tariff, and they have obligation to sell to every consumer which wishes to obtain supply from this supplier. And the other type is the competitive supplier, which sells to only the eligible consumers, like the BPCs in case of Pakistan. And they have the choice whether to sell it or not. They can sell it based on like their bilateral negotiations, while the other supplier, the discos as supplier or the base suppliers, they must offer their supply at regulated, at tariffs regulated by NEPRA. Currently, talking about the transition and the stages, Pakistan is in the single buyer model in which the CPPAG, as an agent of the DISCOs, procures on behalf of all of the DISCOs and from the generator. So we are currently in the single buyer model. So how the single buyer model operate? Is that there are generators on one side, in the middle there is CPPAG, and on the other side there are DISCOs. So and NTDC is the transmission service provider. So all the generators, they invoice to CPPAG, and NTDC also submits invoice to CPPAG. CPPAG transfers this money to the DISCOs in terms of CTR and ETR. DISCOs collect the money from the consumer and make payments to CPPAG, and CPPAG makes payments to NTDC and generators. And today, each PPA costs are equally shared. This is not like certain PPAs are allocated to different players. Same regulated purchase price for each energy and capacity for all DISCOs. And the wholesale price is transferred to regulated electricity tariffs, and there are fuel cost adjustments. And all DISCOs have the same per unit transmission system charge. And the next stage is to move towards the competitive wholesale market, in which there will be DISCOs as supplier, competitive supplier, there will be traders, on the other side there will be generators. So they will be trading in the wholesale market. And the next stage is when the threshold is reduced and new suppliers emerge. So we will go towards the retail competition, when all consumers will have choice to change their supply. With this, we have covered like the brief introduction to the journey and the stages of the market development. Now we are going towards the design, that what is proposed for Pakistan. But before going into the design, everybody always think that what would be the benefit to go into a competitive market. So here are a few. That transparency and efficiency in the wholesale market operations in the power space, this will reduce the variable cost. The intervention we are going in the system operation, we are implementing different tiers. So this will reduce up to 10% of the variable cost, and there will be institutional strengthening. And in the future benefit, the risk will be reduced, and generation costs, they are likely to go down up to 15% through competitive auctions. Measures will be taken to remove the need for sovereign guarantees by reducing the risk. So, and the major risks like avoiding the over and under supply, this will be done through a clear, transparent, accountable manner. So these are the like expected benefits of the future momentum. And there are some principles, like the main principle of the market, that we will incentivize efficiency. The low cost generation must enter the market. And there shall be no arbitrage and free riding opportunities. And there shall be minimum subsidy requirements in order to undertake this transition towards competitive market. There shall be no cost increase for the consumers which do not leave the local DISCO and participate in the market. And there shall always be a levelized playing field for every market player. So coming to the main features, these are on the screen. You can see there are a lot of features. I will be talking about like few today, and the rest will be covered in our upcoming sessions. So what is CTBCM? How trading will take place in CTBCM? So the CTBCM, this is primarily organized or constructed around bilateral contract. Like there will be no central entity. Each player has to buy its need as per its own. There will be like no central entity. Like today there is CPPAG. In future, like there will be DISCOs will be procuring for themselves, and there will be other suppliers which will be doing bilateral contracts. The system operator will establish marginal prices which will be using as reference in the market, as well as also for the settlement of imbalances. And the DISCOs as suppliers, they will procure through competitive bidding, which will be organized by the independent auction administrator, which will result in reduced purchase costs. And the eligible consumers, they will be free to procure from competitive suppliers. Their rates will not be regulated There are like 8 design parameters, and in this session I will briefly talk about 4, which are the major design parameters. That the product, one design parameter is products traded in the market. So in CDBCM there will be like 2 products. One is energy and the other is firm capacity. The energy will be is a product like to supply your consumption, and firm capacity is traded to ensure medium and long-term supply adequacy in the system. And another major design parameter is the price mechanism, that how the market price will be determined. So CDBCM is a cost-based pool, and with there will be single market clearing price. Another is the how the power procurement will take place for the base suppliers. There will be 100% capacity obligations, and the power procurement will be subject to IGCEP and will be procured to a proper plan called the procurement plan. And eligible consumers like the BPCs and the competitive supplier, they will be free to negotiate their contract. And market architecture, in this bilateral, there will be bilateral contract, and this will be complemented with the balancing mechanism for energy and capacity to treat the deviations from the contracted quantities. So the main features of CTBCM on the competitive wholesale market of Pakistan are there will be establishment of independent and partial market operator and system operator. Dispatch operations will be improved through strengthening of the system operator. There will be tool-based security constrained economic dispatch. Generation adequacy will be ensured through capacity obligations. New capacity procurement will be done directly by the DISCOs and will be through centralized auctions run by the independent auction administration. Credit covers will be introduced to cover the non-payment risk. Government supports will be available for the low-performing DISCOs. There will be balancing mechanisms to trade the imbalances on market prices. Legacy PPAs will be commercially allocated to the DISCOs and will be legally administered by the CPPAG. There will be rules and regulations established for market participants to establish their rights and obligations, as well as service providers. In the new context, some flexibilities will be introduced, which we are currently working on. The CPPA, like the market operator, will have a contract registrar and to check the validity of the contracts in the CTBCM, because not all kind of contracts will be allowed. The contracts must follow certain criteria. There will be a commercial code which will go on the operations in the market. Today, one of the key feature of CTBCM, which is the capacity obligations, I will talk briefly about this, and the rest will be coming covered in our upcoming session. Capacity obligations. So what is meant by capacity obligations? The purpose is to introduce security of supply. How this will work? All market participants which represent demands will have the obligation to contract in advance sufficient capacity. By sufficient capacity, we mean contribution to the system peak and reserves to serve its load. It's like when you have a forecasted demand, you must have ensured that you have contracted that capacity, and that capacity is coming online in order to ensure adequacy in the system. So there are no shortages, like you are contracting for what you need. So what this will ensure, that you are neither in surplus nor in shortages. So, and each market participant will be accountable for its demand projections. If it do over forecasting, it will have to bear its repercussion. These capacity obligations, these will be a contribution to ensure medium and long-term security of supply in the system. So these capacity obligations, they will be calculated in advance by MO for like the upcoming 3 years, 5 years, and will MO will inform each market participant in advance in order to make the necessary arrangements. And these will be verified by the contract registrar function of MO. And all future procurements for the regulated consumers, these will be subject to competitive procurements to the extent feasible. This competitive process, they will be subject to NEPRA regulations and oversight. The IAA role would be to consolidate requirements from all DISCOs and to run the competitive auctions. When the bidding process has been completed, the IAA will nominate the successful bidder, which will be required then to approve their tariffs from NEPRA. And after approval of the tariffs, the cost will be passed through to end consumer tariffs. So this is was like the mechanism or important mechanism of the capacity obligation. Next is the CTBCM implementation and monitoring plan. So there, like I mentioned, there are several entities which have to do its actions. First is the MVPD and NEPRA. There are certain actions that needs to be taken by these entities. Like on the MVPD, there is a revision of policy, development of new rules. On NEPRA, like the modification of the regulations, rules, codes, guidelines, approval of these things. Then there are the like implementing entities, which are DPIB, EADB, which will emerge as IAA. So the security package revision, market contacts, institutional restructuring, IA registration on the NTDC as a transmission service provider, as well as the system operator, it has to do some certain actions like the ISMO licensing, institutional restructuring, revision of the grid code, preparation of the connection agreements, ensure transparency. We CPPSG as special purpose trader and market operator has to do certain actions, and there are actions on the DISCO side, like the institutional strengthening, which is like implementation of the market implementation department, connection agreements, have financial health assessments, and regarding the monitoring mechanism. So the monitoring mechanism is such that there are working groups at each implementing entity, and there is also a board committee at CPPAG, which is overseeing all these activities. And there is another monitoring layer, which is the MIMG, which is comprised of MOE and NEPRA, and there are members of planning committee, which is overseeing these tasks. And on top of that, the Cabinet Committee on Energy is monitoring implementation of this action. I think with this, we reach the end of the first session. So, come on.
So thank you, Ibrar, for giving us insight and the understanding about the competitive trading bilateral contract market. So in the future, hopefully we'll have detailed session on design and implementation roadmap on regular and frequent intervals. So this is now question and answer sessions. So that I would like to invite Mr. Umar Harun Malik, Head Strategy and Market Development, Mr. Ibrar, Lead Design, and Mr. Shahir Ali, Lead PMO. So one by one, we'll see the questions and we'll try to answer all those questions. If due to shortage of time, some questions are not being addressed, so these will be reached us through CPPA website, question and answer portal that is already available on CPPAG website. So we'll see the first question. So with this, I would like to invite Mr. Umar Harun Malik, Head Strategy and Market Development, to please address the questions.
जी मैं उमर हारून हूँ सो द पहला क्वेश्चन जो है वी विल टेक क्वेश्चन लाइक देयर लाइक 8 टू 10 क्वेश्चंस तो पहला क्वेश्चन था वो एक टाइपो था स्लाइड डेक में जो स्लाइड में हमने लिखा कि चिली जो है उसकी मार्केट 1882 में स्टार्ट हुई इट वाज अ टाइपो बाय द वे इट स्टार्टेड इन 1982 जो लैटिन अमेरिकन जो इलेक्ट्रिसिटी मार्केट में रिफॉर्म्स थे वो स्टार्ट हुए हैं जी लेट 80s और अर्ली 90s में और वो ज़्यादातर जो साउथ अमेरिकन एंड लैटिन अमेरिकन मार्केट्स हैं वहाँ से स्टार्ट हुए सो ये टाइपो था अपॉलोजीज इसको करेक्ट करके आपसे स्लाइड डेक शेयर कर लेंगे दूसरा क्वेश्चन एक आया है जिसमें लिखा है कि 10 CPPA हैव टू अप्लाई फॉर अ लाइसेंस अंडर नेप्रा अमेंडमेंट एक्ट जी बिल्कुल अब पहले CPPA मार्केट ऑपरेटर और एजेंट का रोल कर रहा था और ये दोनों रोल जो हैं वो कॉन्फ्लिक्टिंग है एजेंट ऑफ डिस्कोस जो कि डिस्कोस का राइट्स को प्रोटेक्ट करता है या एक्सरसाइज करता है टू एडमिनिस्ट्रेट द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ डिस्कोस और दूसरा है मार्केट ऑपरेटर का जिसमें मार्केट डेवलपमेंट एंड फैसिलिटेशन है ये सर्विस एक सर्विस प्रोवाइडर का रोल है और ये दोनों रोल्स कॉन्फ्लिक्टिंग थे तो नेप्रा ने जब 2018 में हमें नेप्रा एक्ट आने से पहले ऑथराइजेशन दी अंडर द मार्केट रूल्स 2015 उसके अंदर उसने इट वॉज क्लियरली रिटन बाय द अथॉरिटी कि हम इस कॉन्फ्लिक्ट को दूर करेंगे और मार्केट ऑपरेटर को स्पिन ऑफ करेंगे CPPA से अकॉर्डिंगली नेप्रा एक्ट भी जो है वो सेक्शन 23A जो मार्केट ऑपरेटर लाइसेंसी के बारे में उसकी एलिजिबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया और बी उसके फंक्शंस के बारे में बताता है उसके तहत अंडर सेक्शन 23A एंड बी CPPA विल बी अप्लाइंग फॉर द लाइसेंस टू गेट ए लाइसेंस ऑफ द मार्केट ऑपरेटर एज अ सेपरेट लीगल एंटिटी एंड दैट एप्लीकेशन विल गो टू द रेगुलेटर एज पर प्लान बाय जुलाई दिस ईयर जी The next question was about what is the timeline for amending the rules and regulations in line with the Act Amendment. So, जी जो मैं इस पर ज़्यादातर रोशनी डालना चाहूँगा कि कानून के तहत तो एक टाइमलाइन दी गई थी लेकिन अब जो CTBCM का अप्रूव प्लान है जो नेप्रा ने अप्रूव किया है जो फर्दर इंडोर्स हुआ फेडरल गवर्नमेंट से उसके तहत सबसे पहले 8 एलिजिबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया रूल्स बनने हैं जिसके अंदर पार्टिसिपेंट्स और सर्विस प्रोवाइडर्स जिसको नेप्रा एक्ट के अंदर इंट्रोड्यूस कराया गया सेक्शन 23 में स्पेशली और सेक्शन 17, 18, 19 में भी सर्विस प्रोवाइडर्स में से प्रोविंशियल ग्रिड कंपनी नेशनल ग्रिड कंपनी से लेकर मार्केट ऑपरेटर सिस्टम ऑपरेटर और रजिस्ट्रेशन रूल अंडर सेक्शन 25 जिसके तहत कुछ सर्विस प्रोवाइडर जस्ट लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल ऑक्शनियर और CPPA एज स्पेशल पर्पज ट्रेडर ये वो सर्विस प्रोवाइडर्स हैं जो रजिस्टर्ड हों जो कि रजिस्टर या लाइसेंस होंगे और बाकी जो जैसे ट्रेडर्स हैं सप्लायर्स हैं इनके भी जो रूल्स हैं एलिजिबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया रूल्स वो बन रहे हैं तो ये 8 रूल्स जो हैं इनकी टाइमलाइंस ऐसे हैं कि इनको 2 बैचेस में डिस्ट्रीब्यूट किया गया है फर्स्ट बैच जो रूल्स हैं वो मिनिस्ट्री ने सर्कुलेट भी किए थे, उन पर कुछ स्टेक होल्डर के कॉमेंट्स भी आए हैं, उनको एड्रेस करके बिफोर जून उनकी अप्रूवल फेडरल कैबिनेट से हो जाएगी, और साइमल्टेनियसली जो दूसरा बैच है वो भी नेक्स्ट मंथ होपफुली गवर्नमेंट जो है उसको सर्कुलेट कर देगी कॉमेंट्स के लिए, और उनकी अप्रूवल भी जुलाई अगस्त तक आ जाएगी। टॉकिंग अबाउट द रेगुलेशंस, सो जो रेगुलेशंस स्पेशली इन लाइन विद द होलसेल मार्केट जो नेसेसरी हैं, टू मेंशन अ फ्यू विच आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, नेमली प्रोक्योरमेंट रेगुलेशन, सप्लायर रेगुलेशन एंड अदर्स। सो नेपरा माशाल्लाह उस पर काफ़ी उसने जंप स्टार्ट लिया हुआ है, वो टाइमली उस पर काम कर रहे हैं। जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू मस्ट हैव सीन द ड्राफ्ट दैट नेपरा हैज ऑलरेडी शेयर्ड ऑन द वेबसाइट, तो उस पर मैं आप सबको इंकरेज भी करूँगा कि उसको देखें और उस पर कॉमेंट भी करें। नेपरा ने सप्लायर रेगुलेशन पे ड्राफ्ट जो है पब्लिश कर दिया है, इसके बाद प्रोक्योरमेंट रेगुलेशन है और कुछ और रेगुलेशंस हैं जो आएंगी, और एंटिसिपेटेड ये है कि बाय द एंड ऑफ दिस ईयर वी विल हैव द सूट ऑफ ऑल नेसेसरी रेगुलेशंस व्हिच आर इंपॉर्टेंट टू रन सीटीबीसीएम। जी नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन क्या था? नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन है जी कि सीटीबीसीएम मॉडल में क्या सीबीपीए फर्दर कोई प्रोक्योरमेंट करेगा कि नहीं करेगा, या डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन कंपनीज करेंगे। आई थिंक इसको तो अबरार ने काफी डिटेल में एड्रेस भी किया कि मूविंग फॉरवर्ड सीपीपीए जो है एज एन एजेंट ऑफ डिस्कोस वो कोई फर्दर प्रोक्योरमेंट नहीं करेगा, सिर्फ जो डिस्कोस जो है न्यू कैपेसिटीज वो बायलैटरली कॉन्ट्रैक्ट करेंगे, और उसका प्रोसेस के बारे में बराड ने हाईलाइट किया कि वो अपनी डिमांड फोरकास्ट करेंगी और बेस्ड ऑन देयर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन टू सिस्टम पीक्स जो भी उनका क्वांटम निकलेगा जो और जो क्वांटिटी और जो टाइप ऑफ जनरेशन स्पेसिफाई होगी या आउटपुट होगी एक्सेप्ट की आईजीसीईपी की, उसके तहत वो बायलैटरल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स जो हैं डिस्कोस के साथ किए जाएंगे। तो डिस्कोस खुद इन फ्यूचर में कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स करेंगी, सीबीपीए फर्दर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट नहीं करेगा। ठीक है जी, एक क्वेश्चन है जी, आई एम जस्ट रीडिंग इट टू जस्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड, जस्ट गिव मी 30 सेकेंड्स। एसपीटी जो है वो सर्विस प्रोवाइडर तो जरूर है, क्योंकि देखा जाए तो डे वन से सारी मार्केट ही जो है वो लेगेसी कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स है, आपके पास कोई नए कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स नहीं है। तो एक दोस्त का क्वेश्चन ये था कि क्योंकि वो एसपीटी लेगेसी कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स को मैनेज कर रही है तो वो सर्विस प्रोवाइडर नहीं है। वो बिल्कुल सर्विस दे रही है, एजेंसी सर्विस टू डिस्कोस एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिंग इनिशियली द ऑलमोस्ट 100% ऑफ द मार्केट, तो उसकी जो बिलिंग सेटलमेंट पेमेंट्स की जो भी सर्विस है वो स्पेशल पर्पस ट्रेडर वो दे रहा है, तो इट इन दैट सेंस वो सर्विस प्रोवाइडर है। और सीबीपी जैसे मैंने पहले कहा सेक्शन 25 के नीचे जो एलिजिबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया रूल्स फॉर रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक पावर सर्विस प्रोवाइडर्स आ रही है उसके तहत वो रजिस्टर होगी सीबीपीए, और वो एक सर्विस प्रोवाइडर कैटेगरी में फॉल करती रहेगी। नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, देखिए एक क्वेश्चन थोड़ा सा क्लियर नहीं है जिसमें लिखा हुआ है कि शायद कंपैरेटिव बिडिंग इज अ गुड कॉन्सेप्ट बट फंडामेंटली फ्लॉड है। इसकी सक्सेस स्टोरी जो है वो अगरचे शायद पाकिस्तान में इतनी उसकी एग्जांपल्स नहीं मिलती इन टर्म्स ऑफ पावर प्रोक्योरमेंट, हाउएवर ग्लोबल एक्सपीरियंस में तो अगर आप कंपैरेटिव प्रोक्योरमेंट एक ऑप्शन है जिसकी अच्छी कैपेसिटी हो वो सही तरीके से सही प्रोसेस से कंपैरेटिव बिडिंग रन करे, तो जनरली एक्सपीरियंस से ये बात सामने आई है कि अराउंड 20-30% जो कॉस्ट है वो लेवलाइज कॉस्ट जो है वो गिरती है पावर की। सो मतलब दिस इज अ प्रूवन फैक्ट। जी एक क्वेश्चन ये आया है कि जो सिस्टम ऑपरेटर है वो एक बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट पिलर है मार्केट का, तो उसकी वो उसका क्या रोल होगा, उसकी इम्प्रूवमेंट के लिए सीटीबीसी में क्या स्टेप्स हैं। अब्रार ने इसको स्लाइडली टच तो किया था अपनी प्रेजेंटेशन में, लेकिन अपार्ट फ्रॉम जैसे मार्केट ऑपरेटर एक कमर्शियल पिलर है, तो दो जो अगर आप कहें कि दो सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट सर्विस प्रोवाइडर्स कौन से हैं मार्केट में, तो सिस्टम ऑपरेटर और मार्केट ऑपरेटर हैं। ये अगर इनकी इनकी जो परफॉर्मेंस है उनकी कैपेबिलिटी एक लेवल तक अगर नहीं पहुंचती, एक बिलो मिनिमम थ्रेशोल्ड तक, तो हम मार्केट को स्टार्ट नहीं कर सकते, हम मार्केट को स्टार्ट नहीं कर सकते. सो हैविंग सेड दिस, मार्केट ऑपरेटर के भी काफ़ी इंस्टीट्यूशनल एक्शंस हैं, आईटी बेस्ड रीस्ट्रक्चरिंग, सो एंड सो फोर्थ. सिमिलरली सिस्टम ऑपरेटर के भी पीपल प्रोसेस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी से रिलेटेड न्यूमरस सेक्शंस हैं. टू नेम अ फ्यू, फॉर एग्जांपल, सिस्टम ऑपरेटर में पिछले 3 साल से शॉर्ट टर्म डिमांड फोरकास्टिंग, विंड फोरकास्टिंग, इसके अलावा डिस्पैच, जो आपके प्रोडक्शन सिमुलेशन मॉडल्स हैं जिसमें यूनिट कमिटमेंट और स्कैड के मॉडल्स हैं, उन पे वो उनके टूल्स लाइक फ्लेक्सोस, एसडीडीपी, एनसीपी उन्होंने डिप्लॉय किए हुए हैं. उन्होंने स्पेशल सेक्शन बनाया हुआ है जो कि इसको पिछले 1 से 2 साल से यूज़ कर रहा है. ये सारी वो इनपुट्स हैं जो कि एक अच्छे डे अहेड डिस्पैच के लिए और फिर रियल टाइम यूनिट कमिटमेंट के लिए यूज़ होंगे इन एब्सेंस ऑफ स्कैडा. और यही इनपुट्स एंड आउटपुट्स जो सिस्टम ऑपरेटर है फिर अपनी वेबसाइट पे पब्लिश करेगा फॉर द सेक ऑफ ट्रांसपेरेंसी. बेहतर डिस्पैच जो होगा, जितना बेहतर, जितना रिलायबल क्रेडिबल डिस्पैच होगा, ट्रांसपेरेंट डिस्पैच होगा, उसी से फिर जो आपकी मार्जिनल प्राइसेस हैं जो कि इम्बैलेंसेस और ट्रेडिंग के लिए यूज़ होंगी वो फॉर्म होंगी. तो ये वो बेसिक चीज़ें हैं जो कि पिछले 2-3 साल में इंटरवेंशन सिस्टम ऑपरेटर में चल रही हैं. इसके अलावा सिस्टम ऑपरेटर में फर्दर इन्वेस्टमेंट्स हो रही हैं, फॉर एग्जांपल वहाँ पे उनकी रीस्ट्रक्चरिंग की जा रही है, उनके एसओपीस फर्दर इन्हांस किए जा रहे हैं, ट्रेनिंग एंड कैपेसिटी बिल्डिंग के सेशंस हो रहे हैं उनके साथ फर्दर, ताकि दे विल बी रेडी इंशाल्लाह बाय द टाइम द मार्केट स्टार्ट. सो वी विल हैव टू पिलर्स, टेक्निकल एंड कमर्शियल पिलर्स, वेल ऑपरेशनल एंड फंक्शनिंग रेडी, ताकि एक क्रेडिबल और ट्रांसपेरेंट तरीके से हम मार्केट को रन कर सकें. जी, इसके अलावा आई थिंक फर्दर क्वेश्चंस अभी आए हैं. ठीक है जी, विद दिस इट्स अबाउट टाइम, 12 बज गए हैं, 1 घंटे का सेशन हो गया है. तो दिस इज नॉट द लास्ट चांस, अगर फर्दर आए हैं जो हम अभी नोट नहीं कर सके तो मैं रिक्वेस्ट ये करूँगा, शायद हमारे दोस्त ने पहले कमाल ने ये बताया था कि एक पोर्टल है हमारी वेबसाइट पे, उसका एड्रेस भी आप यहाँ टाइप कर दें ताकि सबको बताओ कि कहाँ जाना है. वहाँ पे अपने आप क्वेश्चंस टाइप करेंगे, वो ऑटोमेटिकली हमारे पोर्टल पे हमारे से विजिबल हो जाएंगे और उसका फिर आंसर हम सबको विजिबल, सबके लिए हम विजिबल कर देंगे. इसके अलावा हमारी वेबसाइट पे, CPPA की वेबसाइट पे, एक Q&A का पूरा सेक्शन है जहाँ पे इन क्वेश्चंस के अलावा भी हमने फंडामेंटल, मीडियम और एडवांस क्वेश्चन जो हैं, मिड और एडवांस क्वेश्चन जो हैं और उनके आंसर्स वहाँ पे फ्रिक्वेंटली आस्क क्वेश्चंस के रखे हुए हैं, तो उनको भी हम इंकरेज करेंगे आप उनको देखें. इसके अलावा जो क्वेश्चंस हम अभी, शायद आपने भी जब एज आई वाज स्पीकिंग तो दे वर लाइक बजेस कमिंग आउट, पीपल वर आस्किंग सम फर्दर क्वेश्चंस, बिकॉज द टाइम इज आउट, सो आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट कि आप अपने ये क्वेश्चन जो रह गए हैं इसको हमारे पोर्टल पर डाल दें, हम इनको तमाम क्वेश्चन का आंसर जो है वो हम वेबसाइट पर पब्लिश कर देंगे इंशाल्लाह. थैंक यू वेरी मच जी, विद दिस वी एंड द सेशन. जी, ये वेबिनार की रिकॉर्डिंग जो है वेबसाइट पे अवेलेबल भी कर देना. थैंक यू जी, थैंक्स अ लॉट.